Hello everyone, I'm JG and welcome back to Music Forever, where today we're reviewing the new album from Alice in Chains, Rainier Fog. Now this is the newest album from the grunge legends, best known for releasing projects like Dirt and Jar of Flies back in the early 90s, back when grunge music was really first exploding onto the scene and Alice in Chains were a part of that initial movement. It's been many years since then now, but, you know, they've still been a quality group for the most part since then, even undergoing a vocalist change at one point that I think ended up being pretty solid overall. Not many bands could change up their vocalist and not have, you know, problems ensue for the most part. Typically, that's how most bands, you know, go when they change up their vocalist, but not Alice in Chains. Like, they've been still pretty solid overall. So coming into this project, I was, you know, hopeful that it was going to be pretty good. And overall, this is a project that I think is just average, I guess you could say. I'm very middle of the road with this new album here today. There's certainly some moments on it that I think are good and enjoyable, but there's also some moments I don't care for quite as much, and they end up pretty much evening out about, you know, perfectly for a pretty average experience. The opening track to this album, The One You Know, is probably my favorite cut on this entire project, as I think it's one of the more interesting cuts throughout this. It starts off with these very jagged-sounding guitar riffs that I think are really cool and definitely a bit standout compared to some of the other instrumentals on this project. I think the chorus on this track is also pretty catchy. It's overall just a pretty solid cut. It doesn't really do anything that I would say is super out there or experimental or doesn't really do anything super new for the band, but it's just them doing what they do at their best, really. So I'll take that, and I think it's a really solid song overall. And it's a very good start to the album as well. Unfortunately, with the remaining tracks that follow, my interest in the album just declines sharply, just because I don't really find many of the other cuts on here to be super interesting in their own right. For the most part, the biggest, you know, problem with the project and the, you know, why I feel really bored with much of this project is that so many of these cuts just sound very similar. They all kind of have these, you know, just very samey sounding, kind of grungy, doomy, slower, or almost like stoner kind of rock sounding, mid-paced songs that just kind of go on for, you know, however many minutes the song goes on for before going to the next and the next. For like 50 minutes or so, and there's not much variety really breaking that up. There are some things kind of setting, you know, that do change things up a little bit in terms of their structure, and I'll get to those in a little bit in this review, but for the most part, everything on this album just feels very samey, and as a result, I just find myself getting really bored when listening to this album and just zoning out as well, just because it's not a super interesting, there's nothing really to hook me in outside of that first track. The track Drone does seem to try to change things up a bit by having some different sounding sections thrown into the song. It's not, you know, structured like a typical song or anything quite like that. And on the surface, that seems like it would make the track a bit more interesting. And it does to some extent. It definitely makes it one of the other, you know, standouts, I guess you could say, on the project. But none of the individual components kind of putting, you know, kind of none of the real sections of this song are super interesting in their own right either. And the way that they're kind of put together isn't exactly super interesting either. So it's a song that, you know, looking at its structure, you know, while looking at the structure of the track, it sounds like something that would be interesting on paper, but the execution just leaves a lot to be desired, in my opinion. And you also have the closing track, All I Am, which I also think is another one of the better cuts on here. I do think it goes on maybe a little bit too long. It's the longest cut on this album at a little over 7 minutes in length. I do feel like that could have been shortened a little bit, but the track does have a bit more of an emotional punch to it than some of the other ones on here, and stands out for that reason as well. It's another one of the better cuts on this thing, but outside of, you know, the tracks I've mentioned so far, much of the rest of this project isn't super interesting, really. I mean, there are moments where you'll get a decent guitar riff that sound interesting enough. The, you know, vocals on this thing also sound very good as well. You know, as they've typically done with Alice in Chains, regardless of who's, you know, behind the mic, they always tend to sound good, and they do here as well, but nothing about it, you know, it's good, but it's not, like, outstanding or out of this world or anything quite like that. It's just okay by Alice in Chains standards. It's really not all that much that makes any of these songs as a whole, outside of a couple exceptions, stand out all that much. Some might, like I said, might have like a riff here or there that sounds kind of interesting, a vocal part that sounds kind of interesting here or there, maybe an idea just with the lyrics that's a bit interesting, but the rest of the song itself will kind of drag it down with how mediocre the rest of it sounds. And much of the lyrics on this project, outside of some exceptions like the closing track I mentioned before, are also just pretty standard, nothing really stand out, or nothing that I think is going to be super memorable in the long run for me at least. Nothing really compelling me to return all that much. It's just like, okay, there's not any awful lyrics on this thing, right? Or even bad ones, I'd say, but it's just so middle of the road that I really can't be bothered to care all that much. With how similar much of this album sounds, I really do wish that it was maybe a little bit shorter than it actually ended up being. It's not a super long project by any means, it's around 50-ish minutes in length, but just with how similar a lot of the tracks sound, it just feels like it could drag at times, this project, which I feel like if the tracks were a bit more interesting each, I don't feel like that would have been the case, but it's just a pain kind of to listen to at times with how similar and just monotonous it can get to be. So, overall, I really don't have much to say about this album that I haven't said before, which is kind of surprising considering it's not a super short project or anything quite like that. It's just that I feel like there's so little, like interesting content on this album worth talking about that there's not all that much to say about it. It's just kind of dull all the way through, with the exception of maybe a few couple tracks or maybe some other moments that pop up on some other tracks as well. It's just kind of average, just very middle of the road, just not super interesting. It doesn't sound bad, it's not painful to listen to or anything quite like that, but at the same time, it doesn't really compel me to listen to it again going forward. So yeah, I just feel very average on this project overall, but that's just my own personal opinion, and you could feel free to have your own as well. In fact, feel free to leave it in the comment section down below. I greatly appreciate seeing that. And while you're down there, make sure to leave a like on the video and subscribe to the channel for more music-related content, things like album reviews, track reviews, countdown lists, all that good stuff. So if you want to see that, make sure you subscribe. And thanks for watching, guys. Stay golden.